Well, that has also been much discussed. Not so much Bloomberg, which I've heard that possibility, unlikely in the extreme, or Hillary Clinton, because after all, she does, you know, she's still got those 18 million votes. She is a very interesting figure. You would never have expected this in a million years, but a lot of Obama loyalists have already left the administration, and she's, you know, one of the last people standing. I spent some time with her, interviewed her, profiled her for Newsweek. She appears to really enjoy her job, not that I think she's given up on her presidential aspirations. But we did ask the president this very question just this past week. We interviewed him and about the idea of a Biden-Hillary switch. He said it was not going to happen, which is what you would expect him to say. I also think it's unlikely because I think that Biden has been a critical part of Obama's administration in more ways than people realize. I just profiled him for the National Journal this week, and they have a kind of a Lennon-McCartney thing going there between the two of them, where you know, Biden can't shut up. He speaks out on every issue. He's very knowledgeable. And Obama, which is his want, can just kind of sit back and let the battle play out and have Biden sort of play his bad cop to his good cop. So I think that he kind of likes Biden where he is, and you know, Hillary is probably going to stay out the first term as Secretary of State and then maybe go off and think about 2016. I think it's unlikely in the extreme that that happens. Frankly, there's very not much of a history to doing switches like that. If you look at the most of presidential election campaigns, it happened. I mean, FDR switching out Wallace for Truman was one of the last ones, I think. I'm sorry. Yes, but in modern political history, it very rarely happens. You may remember there was a lot of discussion about Quayle and Bush. Didn't happen, or even Reagan and Bush. And so I do think that that's not likely to happen, and Obama is going to have to live or die as a candidate in 2012 on the basis of his own wherewithal. And I think he probably realizes that in the end, people don't vote for vice presidential candidates, wherever they are. He needs to retrieve what he once was. I do think that one of the liabilities with Biden has been that they're both pragmatists. There hasn't been a clear, crisp message coming out of this administration, one of the reasons they've lost control of the agenda. Does anyone remember the new foundation speech? See? The New Deal, we remember the New Deal 80 years later, but Obama gave a speech called the New Foundation for America in April of 2009. This was supposed to be his New Deal. And I think it's just further evidence of how much he's lost control of the agenda that no one remembers it 18 months later. And that's what he's gotta get back. You know, the guy was seen as having this golden tongue on the campaign trail, couldn't say a wrong thing. Even when Jeremiah Wright, you know, came out, he said the right things, and now he can't seem to say the right things, and he seems to be saying the wrong things. I think, you know, he's been too careful. He's been too cautious. He's been taking middle course on everything. They did all of these reforms, healthcare, financial reform, and yet people aren't very happy with it because they're kind of not very good bills, not very good laws. You know, they're kind of half-assed, frankly, and so they're a little peevish, the Obamites, that they're not getting more credit for it. But you know, the people are not enthusiastic. My own view, my own analysis of Obama is that, frankly, there was a little bit of hubris coming in. I think he started to believe his own press that he was this going to be this great transformational figure. And I think when he took on healthcare, it was a bridge too far. It was just too much. He didn't understand the political temper out there. He didn't understand how angry the public was. And I think this was just a tipping point for the Tea Party movement. And he wasn't really analyzing, and he wasn't getting good advice from his advisors like Larry Summers about how deep the economic crisis really was. I mean, look at what they were telling us back in the early days of the administration about the stimulus plan. This is going to be enough. We think we're going to be okay. You know, the unemployment's going to drop. They were wrong. This was a very, very deep systemic crisis that stemmed from this crisis on Wall Street, and I don't think the president, up until relatively recently, what I mean is the last year or so, has really understood how deep it was. So I think that he made some serious political miscalculations. He probably understands them. At this point, he's a brilliant guy. And there's just a question of how he's going to adjust politically.